Welcome to another episode of the Epic Family Road Trip.
In last week's episode of the Epic Family Road Trip, as we continued on our journey north through British Columbia, one of our Jeep's windshields was severely damaged by a bird strike. After getting the windshield replaced, we continued on our way north, camping each night surrounded in beautiful wild nature. This week, we carry on up the Cassiar Highway from Ningunsaw Provincial Park to Dease Lake. This time of year, the autumn colors are vibrant and amplify the magnificent beauty of the landscapes all around us.
The entrance to a big mine, and as soon as we got past that, the road became a lot smaller, and as you can see, it's some single lane bridges and no center line, much smaller road, and we've only seen one truck in the last couple hours. Wow, this is beautiful.
Today because we keep pulling over at all these gorgeous little spots. This one has the beautiful river in the background and mist in the mountains up here. And
it's kind of a neat little piece of history. So what this sign is talking about is the original telegraph line that linked, it looks like it linked Dawson City, which is way up there in Yukon, with Vancouver. So way back in 1898, they put it in. It's 1900 miles of line, and it followed the railway. So kind of where the highway is, or the two-lane highway that we're on, it's called the Cassiar Highway. It follows the river almost all the way, and I guess that's the easiest place to make a road, but it first went in the railway, and then the telegraph line, and then the road that we're on now. But they said there's cabins along the way that these, I guess, telegraphers used to live in, a very isolated cabins, and they're still standing today, so wilderness travelers can sit, take residence in these cabins every once in a while. Kind of neat. Up at the Kuachan General Store. It's the last place to fuel up before a huge long stretch, so we're gonna fill both our tanks. The reserve tanks come in handy up here, I'll tell you what. But the school kids are walking by, and the teacher that's leading them has a rifle slung over her shoulder. That's kind of cool for way up here. I mean, there's bears, there's grizzlies. That's neat to see.
After a beautiful day's drive, we found a camp for the night on the beautiful shores of Dease Lake.
Nice.
Pulled out of the Dease Lake campground. What a beautiful place. Definitely be marked on the map, but it's at the top end of Dease Lake, and you could, the first driveway, just drive in, and if no one's there, you can't find a better campground. So we had a really good sleep, and now we are heading further north towards Yukon. Stopped in the little town of Dease Lake, it's called, and got Wi-Fi there. You can get free Wi-Fi at this tiny little college. They give you a password and everything. So that was good because we haven't had Wi-Fi and or cellular coverage in days. So we got caught up on the important stuff. And we spoke with some locals there, and they told us about this road, Telegraph Creek Road. And it's a dirt road off of the Cassiar Highway. Takes you around to Mount Edziza, I think it's called, Provincial Park. And it's just wild out here, and nobody out here. And we're looking forward to finding a great camp spot and spend the night somewhere down there in view of Mount Edziza, if possible. So come with us way back into the backcountry. Here, waterfall. Reminds me of goosenecks. Not quite as steep down as goosenecks, but still a big cliff and a gorgeous canyon in the background.
Just gorgeous though.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
We'll be fine. We're just gonna
pull away from this crack. That doesn't inspire any confidence as to how long that's going to stay there, but it's probably been there for a long time.
Dan, go.
You go, Dad?
Yeah. Dan.
You could crawl through there, but I don't really feel like getting stuck to get in there, so I think that would be the best spot.
Well, this would be interesting if we can make it through. We just have to go back up.
Tune for next week's episode as we continue on our journey through northern British Columbia before having to completely rethink our plans at the provincial border to the Yukon Territory.
Time.
We'll see you down the road.